So if you want to move it, I don't want to move it.
And then these arms never do shit.
They have to stay behind each other. Cool.
There you go. They're doing it.
I like shots. Pretty
easy.
Good one.
It's Halloween's coming. Halloween's coming. If y'all make a dope costume, that could be the shit. All right, y'all ready?
Dope costume.
So I have three questions to ask you related to dance in your life.
Mm-hmm.
The first question is, why did you get into dance?
Well, at first, I started dancing because both of my parents are musicians. So they were always playing funk music and soul jazz music. And I was actually dancing as a baby on their music, you know? And I was always also in front of the television, mimicking Janet Jackson or Britney Spears or that's how I got into dance, and then like my parents were always super motivating. And yeah, so at the age of 5 I actually started with dance classes, like choreography and stuff. And at the age of 9 like my mom found a popping teacher, and I saw how he was doing like all these isolations, and I was like, oh wow, that's magic, you know. So that's how I got into it, basically.
Wow, yeah. That is awesome. It goes back to popping, that's just how you do.
Right, yeah. Right. So I fell in love with it when I was 9 and I'm still doing it.
Oh, that's really cool. My second question is, what has dance done for you physically, mentally, emotionally? What has dance done for you?
It has done a lot, definitely. Like, for me, actually, dance is a study to who I am. So, like through my dance, I found more about my culture, like through traveling, like I met more people. It was opening up me, as in like I got more confidence. It was a way to communicate with other people too, because at first I was like very silent person. And through dance, like you know how to communicate also with non-verbal language. And like mentally, yeah, like all the emotions that you have, you can like relieve it through dance, and it's something.
It's a release, a release of feelings.
Yeah.
Would you say you release feelings, not just happiness, but sadness, maybe anger? Do you release other feelings as well?
Actually, I feel like I don't have that much anger because I dance. So, like, I have like happy feelings, or sometimes maybe sadness, but because you immediately have like an out. To show how you feel, actually. I don't have to feel that way, like I don't have to crop it up, or I never have that feeling. It's just more like
free,
natural, open,
free. Little smile, so happy. You
right,
can see.
Yeah
that is awesome. So my last question is, what advice would you give the next generation, or people that are thinking of getting into dance? What advice would you give them? Specifically popping.
Specifically popping, like, I think it's always important to like study the history of the dance, because in a way, like, you can add something to the dance style if you know where it's coming from, what are the motives that people are, why are people actually doing this dance? And I feel like if you understand that and you preserve that culture, then you can add something of yourself, and actually you understand why you are creating something. Because I think like back in the days, like they were creating too, like they started out of nothing, but it was they always, for instance, in popping culture, they wanted to show their character, they wanted to do something different than the other person. And then suddenly like they like created a foundation. So I think it's definitely important to learn about that foundation, but it's also important to always put something from yourself into the dance, and then, like you preserve the whole culture, but you give your piece to it.
Wow, that was beautifully said. And because of that, I have to ask one last question, because it was really good. I had three.
Yeah.
What advice, it could be dance, not dance, it could just be life, would you tell someone? Just what piece of advice comes to your mind that you would like to tell the world or someone?
Right.
Well, it could be anything.
Well, maybe based on how I live, like I combine dance with school, with everything. Like, to me, dance is also something that keeps me in balance. So, like for instance, if you decide to live in the system, which a lot of dancers don't do, but if you decide to, like for instance, go to work or like study or anything, just use as like dance as what I said, like to relieve your emotions or whatever. And it definitely keeps you in balance for like to do great stuff. To me, if I would dance the whole day, I would feel like I'm not using my brain. If I would only study, I would get crazy too, because I'm like, I need to use my body physically. So for me, like to find that balance between that, it makes me successful in both. I advise that to people too, to try that, you know.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for answering those questions. Give a round of applause for our guests on our show.
And action.
So your name is?
CJ Wright.
And what is your dance style?
Flexer.
And where are you from?
Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Okay, so you moved from Pennsylvania and now you're living in LA, correct? And yes, how long you been out here?
8 months, actually.
Okay, 8 months. So what I want to know is, what would you tell the people back at home or in PA, or even dancers in general in other states that are thinking about coming to LA? What advice would you give them? What would you want them to know?
Have a plan for your plan.
Can you explain a little more?
So, like, we moved out here, it was like we had everything ready and everything was good, and then, you know, like, jobs sometimes don't transfer the right way. Then you have like ideas that you had that you're gonna do your job and it doesn't happen, so then you have to have something back up, because if you don't, then you're just out here trying to figure it out and trying to pay rent, and it's over a band. It's like it's a lot. It's much different than PA, because in PA, living out there was a little bit way cheaper, like, even like, you know, like gas and all that stuff, everything is just way cheaper. So moving to a place where rates go up, you know, the talent goes up, just because, you know, there's people here that move all around the world that come to LA because they think it's this dream and stuff like that. It's still the same. Like, if I didn't come here with a work ethic like I was at home, there was no way I'd be doing the things I'm doing right now. You know what I'm saying? So it's still the same energy that I had at home. Like, you know, I'm fighting to be whatever it is, like helping to show the flexing and pushing flex as a group, you know, showing that we're doing this too from PA. And I went to New York like every other, like, for 4 years, just battling, just to show that we can do it just like you guys, you know what I'm saying? So now that I have a little recognition with my name out there, it was like I felt it was time for me to move out here and just pursue a different dream. So the advice I would say is, like, if you're gonna do that, you just have to make sure you have a plan for your plan, because a lot of things don't work out the way you think they are. Mm-hmm. Like, I was supposed to come here and do Lyft, like, with a bang, but you got here and you have to be 25, I'm only 23. So now I'm 24, but it's like, still, that whole time was like a month or so trying to figure out where I'm going to work and money wise, because you can come here with a good amount of money, but it goes quick. Like, everything goes quick. You know, you pay money, you pay rent, you pay a couple things, and it's just like, say you have electric. Yeah, it's like, take what you have and really understand that it's not for granted, like with your parents and everything. And then if you're going to do this, you got to really come here with the dream, like, because that's the only reason why we're still here, because the dream was so real. Like, that's what I wanted to do my whole life. She wanted to do her thing, you know what I'm saying? So.
That's crazy. Well, that's a crazy story, and I think it's interesting, because I think some people have this fantasy, I'm just going to go and do it, and I'm just going to figure it out. And I think it's nice to hear, to kind of plan it, like, kind of think about it, plan it out. Don't just blow your money and then, you know, figure it out then. Something I want to ask you is, dance-wise, like, what has dance done for you physically, mentally, spiritually, socially? What would you say dance has done?
There was a time, like, in my life where, like, I don't even talk to my parents. Like, me and my parents were not as close as we used to. I was, like, homeless for a long time, for, like, 3 or 4 years. So that's what I'm saying. Like, when you come out here with the dream, like, you got to make sure it's the right one. You feel me? So, like, that's what I mean by, like, dance was, like, my savior. That's what it is here. So now I'm doing bigger things with the dancing scene. And it's because of all the people around me and what I'm, and my work ethic itself, you know, and the people I surround myself with have the work ethic themselves. So it's, like, they are doing their thing. I'm doing my thing. We collab. We talk. We share ideas. You know, we're doing this. Like, it's, like, there's things to it that dance can change. It could change a person. It could save a life. It could do all that stuff. So if you teach it to these kids and, you know, show them what's going on and teach it to other people, all ages, whatever it is, It could change a person's life. It could be what they needed that way out, because you never know. Like, life is hard. Like, life's always a struggle. There's depression, there's anger, there's all that stuff. So it's always good to have that backup plan, and always have that feeling for dance, because dance is always gonna be there, you know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what. So it's like, it's cool to see other people make it and be good in what they're doing and push that as itself.
That's dope, man. I think it's really good to hear, like, what you said about the advice you're kind of giving. Because that was my next question, what advice you would give to the next generation, and you were already telling them, like, what to do.
You gotta push it.
Yeah.
Like, if you want it, you gotta do it. Because that's the thing, is I said I was gonna move here 2 years ago. I never did. I just kept going, like, over and over, and the years kept going, and it's kept going. Like, yeah, I'm moving in January. No, I'm gonna come visit in September. Oh, no, I'm gonna come in the summer. You know, like, you just gotta do it. Like, I would say do it, but just make sure you have your plans correct. You feel me? Like, just in case something does happen, because anything can happen.
Right.
Like, your car could break down halfway through. You know, what are you going to do? Like, you have to pay for something, or somehow you have to get yourself there. U-Haul could break, or your flight could be canceled. Like, what, you know what I'm saying? Like, anything, you can get there and they don't have your name on the lease or something. You know, you have to plan and plan and plan, like, months in advance, make sure everything's ready, and make sure the backup plan. Now I'm living pretty good. Like, everything's all right. You know, like, it's still, like, struggling, but, like, it's not, like, struggle like it was before. It's just, like, you know, this rent's still a little bit more expensive than we're used to, but we're getting into the routine and pushing it now, so it's a little bit easier. But for a new generation, if you're gonna come here, just make sure you're ready for that transition, man. Like, and make sure you really wanna push this, because a lot of people, I've noticed, like, a lot of people don't like just like dancing would be like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like you want to see someone who's actually being that positive energy and talking around. You want to be around that person. If you have that vibe where I'm the best, then there's no, you know, it's never going to be easy for you. So like, that's something that I would definitely stress, is like, you just want to be generally open to everything. Because as a flexor, it's harder, because to come out here and dance, to do what I do, it's cool for people to see, but it's hard to push it because people associate it with popping, people associate it with certain different styles, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of cool to see that a lot of people accept me for who I am, and I'm always open to learn new things, like growing in the Elmer space, learning the popping stuff. Like, I think it's cool. Like, I think it's cool to learn popping, just housing, all those different styles, taking choreo especially. Like, choreo heads really enjoy that, like seeing that someone who freestyles is here to take class, you know what I'm saying? So I would definitely push to be able to open your mind to everything, especially here in LA, because LA is where, like, that's where you're gonna see everything the most. So, that's what I would definitely say.
That's CJ for you.
Your name is?
Mick.
Mick, and your style of dance is?
I do animation, popping, and I break.
Wow. If you had to pick one style from that list that you feel the closest to, which one would you pick?
Animation and breaking are about the same.
Animation, cool. And where are you originally from?
I am originally from Connecticut.
Oh, shit. Oh, really? Okay. And how long you been out here for?
I've been in LA for maybe 2.5 years, I think.
Really? Wow. Who would you say are some of the people that kind of you found interest or kind of brought you into the dance community or the popping world?
I don't know what stage. For LA particularly? Or?
Connecticut.
I never danced in Connecticut.
Really?
I just grew up there.
So you moved out here, and when did you start dancing?
I started dancing about 6 years ago in Boston.
Boston, okay. So Boston's where it started.
Yeah.
Okay, and who would you say inspired you or kind of gave you, introduced you to that world?
I had a friend that was a b-boy. And that was my connection. I had wanted to start for a long time, but just sort of like didn't have the motivation. And then I had a sort of like quarter life crisis midway through my, I was in Boston 5 years, so like about third year there. Sort of had a quarter life crisis. Was like, all right, I gotta, you know, my 20s are disappearing. I gotta start this. And so I finally started, hit up my friend, started breaking. Pretty soon after that, I sort of, by a whim, I found out about popping for the first time, took some classes, and then I just stuck with it.
Wow, that's really dope. What would you say dance has done for you physically, mentally, different areas of your life? What has it done for you?
It definitely provides a great, balance to in my career. I've always been more of an intellectual study a lot, that kind of thing. So it definitely provides the physical side of the life experience or whatever you want to call it. It also is another avenue of something I can really try to get really good at. Which I think is really interesting, as well as at the same time have a creative aspect to it. So I can try to develop and express different things with it. I joke around, but dancing, I feel like, gives me superpowers. I'm sort of after all the sort of superpower-y type of moves, things that are very illusional or stuff like that. That's a fun part about it.
That's awesome, the fun part. Being able to pretend.
Yeah.
Being able to pretend, just like back in my child, when you're sort of child growing up pretending, being able to tap into that imagination. That is awesome. What advice would you give the next generation or people that want to get into this dance?
Be patient. It takes time to build skills. There are no shortcuts. There are ways of doing things more efficiently and with learning. You can learn more efficiently, but that's not related to dance per se, that's related to just learning. Also, take care of your body. Street dance, I think particularly, partly because it doesn't have that much history compared to a lot of other more developed traditional dances. We really don't know about, like, you know, what moves are putting what stress on certain parts of the body. We kind of just get injured, and then at that, when we get injured, then we're like, all right, right, let's go to the physical therapist and start learning about the body finally. I think we would really greatly benefit from more knowledge early on about preparing the body to do the moves that we're trying to do.
Nice. That's awesome. Well, here you have it. So, today we have Shockwave. Awesome, awesome. You're from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, yeah. Born and raised.
Born and raised, yeah.
That's dope. So just thank you again for, you know, spending some time to answer these questions.
Yeah, no problem.
My first question is, why did you get into dance?
By accident, actually. I found a Boyz II Men CD a long time ago. That was my first CD I ever got at a garage sale. And then from that, not saying I was great at singing, but I got into singing. And then when I hit high school, I was trying to get into that. And around that time, you had like Backstreet Boys and NSYNC and all that. And I'm like, I gotta learn how to dance too? That's crazy. But then in that process, learning dance, I learned that that's what my passion was.
Your passion. Dance was your passion.
Yeah.
Wow, that's awesome. How would you describe what dance does for you?
Dance, man. Dance is life. It's like, it can really be truly anything you want it or need it to be. So it can be obviously like a physical outlet, an emotional outlet. But it teaches you a lot of life lessons, and you might not understand that right away, obviously, because you have to go through life. But, you know, literally everything that comes along with dance, you can apply to life. So it's pretty amazing.
What advice would you give someone that's thinking about getting into dance or even the dance community? What advice would you want to tell them?
That's tough, because I don't know what they want. And then from there, I can maybe tailor that advice. I would say, don't expect to just be amazing or undefeated or all these things that are painted, whether it's through TV or movies or the impressions that people give or something they write online. Everyone goes through something. No one is 50-0. Even Mayweather lost as an amateur, you know what I mean? So, who's not a dancer as far as I know, but as an example of someone who's very successful and so-called undefeated.
Right.
So everyone has taken their L's and they've learned from it. Everyone's failed, so don't be afraid to fail. That might be a good way to, a good focus. If you throw yourself in the fire sooner, you'll probably come out of Phoenix a little sooner.
Nice. Yeah. I like that. And I have one more question. You may already have answered it just from what you previously said. Mm-hmm. But from all your experiences in life, it could be dance, it could be anything, jobs, yeah, relationships. If you could give someone just one piece of advice, what would that be?
So much advice to give. One piece of advice.
If only one thing you could one thing you could tell that person,
yeah,
and that's the only thing you could tell them.
You know what? I feel like sometimes people, especially nowadays, there's too much information. We have too much access to information to the point where we're confused and we don't even know what to look for half the time, because we're just bombarded with new information. So maybe I would say, let life be your teacher a little bit more. So instead of contemplating and really trying to understand it without doing the footwork, so to speak, without doing it in the physical form, just go out there and do whatever it is you're passionate about. Even in that moment, like, you're thinking about, what if this happened? Okay, shut everything else off for a second. Go do that, see what's up. And life will let you know what's up. Like, win or lose, you're gonna gain something from it that day. Yeah.
That was awesome. For real, thanks for that.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, man.
Hey.
That's Shockwave.
Yeah.
So, your name is?
Nikki.
And you are from?
Chicago.
And now you're living in?
Los Angeles.
And you've been here for 1 month?
1 month.
Okay. Cool. Mm-hmm. 1 month. Have you learned anything in 1 month?
It's expensive as fuck.
How are you surviving?
I have a really fantastic cousin who's helping me out.
Oh, that's awesome because you live with your cousin, correct?
I do.
Then do you work?
I do.
What do you do?
I teach dance.
Oh, you teach dance. How'd you make that happen?
I've been teaching for almost 10 years.
10 years. How did that start off?
Quit college. Long story short, quit college. Didn't know what I wanted to do. Hit rock bottom. Went on Craigslist. Saw an ad for a ballroom instructor. And I was like, why not?
And what style of dance do you do?
I'm proficient in animation in Popeye.
Okay. And where are you originally from?
Bay Area.
Bay Area. Now you're living in?
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles. What would you tell people, what advice would you give to people from the Bay Area that are thinking about moving out here?
Just have a plan and make sure, you know, you do what you love when you get out here. You know, you have to get a regular job, of course, at first. Everything's hard, but, you know, if you just continue to push, you can do anything you want to do.
Nice. That's awesome. Now, back to your style of dance. How did you get into dancing?
Honestly, I've always just had a knack for it. But really, it's probably from the U.S. Army movies and, you know, Step Up and all the dance movies. And then I kind of got more into freestyle dancing, watching Nonstop, watching Pop and John. Mm. And just kind of tweaked my style to, you know, where I am today.
Mm, nice. Where would you like to take your style? Where would you like to take your dance in the future?
I love to travel. I love to travel the world. I love to travel to Tokyo. I love to travel to Germany, I love to travel to Russia, anywhere, Paris, London. Just explore the world, you know, and really try to get back, teach what I know, and go from there.
Mm. So let's say, how old are you?
I'm 27.
27, so let's say 10 years into the future, so you'll be 37. What would you have liked to accomplish, or where would you like to be at 37?
I want to be able to teach my style of dance around the world. I want everybody to know who I am for my style of dance, as well as what else I do. I do custom shoes. So yeah, I plan on opening up my own shop for that as well.
Custom shoes, can you tell us a little bit of what is that?
I paint on shoes pretty much for a living. So any like one-of-one design that you want, like it's your shoe. You feel me? Like, if you want it, if you have an idea and you want it and I do it for you, somebody else wants that exact idea, I will never do that for them. It is your shoe. So you got the only one in the world.
Wow, that is really crazy. How could people find you if they are interested in getting a custom shoe?
You can follow me on JYWES Creations, JAYWES Creations. And yeah, just hit me up. Hit me in the DM and I answer all my DMs.
That's dope. One last question. What would you tell someone that looks up to you? Let's say they see your dance and be like, wow, look, I want to be like that. I want to be like him. What would you tell that person?
I don't want you to be like me. I want you to be better than me. Mm-hmm. Because there's only so much I'm going to be able to do in this life, you know. But if they're like me at that age, you know, then what's to say they can't be better when they're my age? You feel me? So just strive to be, you know, the best you can be.
Mm-hmm. And I guess one more question just came to my mind. Again, if you could just give one piece of advice to a person, it could be dance related, it could be relationship related, lifestyle, whatever. What would you want to tell that person?
Follow your dreams. Don't let anybody tell you can't do something. Because at the end of the day, I mean, it's your life. Nobody else is living your life but you, and you taking care of yourself. So that's how you got to do it.
Yeah, I appreciate that, man.
Appreciate you.
Is the set ready?
Yeah, it's the action.
Solo dance classes like tap and jazz and all that kind of stuff.
Sorry, it's... We can't have anything like that if we're gonna... Oh, fuck me. Shockwave. Shock the first name and then Wave Lasseter.
What's up, man? Shockwave. Nice to meet you.
Awesome. Nice to meet you too, man.
Cool.
So my question is...
Nah.
That's not part of it, so...
Happy birthday to you. Oh, it's not midnight yet. It's almost midnight, guys.
Why are you laughing?
You're not high.
I'm not. I'm high. Bro, he's just making me laugh.
I'm high.
Okay. All right.
That's right.
Hey, I have a smile all the time.